Okay, let's see what we got. I've seen worse though. All right, so basically the owner's doing a whole refresh on the car. The car is kind of at that point where if you don't fix it, it's gonna rot away, but it's still at the point where if you do fix it, it's got a lot of potential. But the first thing he wanted us to take care of was stuff like this. So we're gonna go ahead and clean this all up and do a very professional job. Now, before we start working on this vehicle, we have to disconnect the negative terminal. The main reason is safety. There's an electric cooling fan on this car, and it kind of turns on whenever it wants, whenever it's hot. So to avoid any injuries or any complications, we're going to just disconnect the negative terminal. That way, we're safe. Okay, the first thing I notice under this hood are butt crimps. There is a time and a place for these things, not under the hood of this car. As you can see right here, I'm just fiddling around with it, and it just fell right apart. Now, before I get too ahead of myself, this car is 100% functional, so we're not going to just cut every single wire we attach. We're going to do one at a time, that way we reattach the wires that we know work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put shrink tube on everything, get rid of these connections, we're going to solder it all together, and then at the very end we're going to lume the whole thing and make it look nice and clean. So we're going to solder and shrink tube every single wire. Now a lot of this wire in here is pretty old, so it's going to be a little bit harder for us to solder on because it's a little bit corroded. But keep in mind, this car is from the 60s, and it's kind of like the hot rodder's choice, so a lot of guys have worked on this car, guys and girls have worked on this car, and you know, it definitely didn't have an installer's touch. But we want to make this thing first reliable before we make it fancy. I found another issue with the wiring here. Now, right here we got a wire going across, but what this is over here, that's our throttle linkage for the carburetor and everything. And this wiring is rubbing right against it. So every time you're throttling this car, it's rubbing against this wire. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and lume this, and we're going to secure it up high. That way we can get lots of clearance away from any moving linkage. Okay, we've gone ahead and fixed the problem. We have the wire secured up. Lumed it to make it look nicer and just protect it a little bit more. But now you can see it's nice and far away from that throttle linkage. Now all the wires by the blaster coil over here, we've gone ahead and shortened a bunch of them, rerouted them, and make it look a little bit cleaner. It's all lumed again to protect it all. So we've pretty much completed our repair, cleaned up a bunch of the wiring. Didn't want to do anything crazy on this. The customer didn't have a ton of money for us to do a wire tuck or anything, but it's definitely cleaned up a lot more under the engine bay, and the car's a lot more reliable. All we gotta do now is just test it.